Here they come.
It's four adults or four grown people.
Well, I think one's a girl.
Exaggerated situation that a parent imagines to mark that, right? It could range.
All right, so we heard a report of a murder suicide, family of four, all dead, two females, two males. Nobody knows anything else other than that. So we're headed there now because it happens to only be 5 miles away. Not even gonna need a freeway. Just gonna drive down these streets, Marguerite, to Oso, turn right.
Mark Burr is sitting in front of the students, masturbating all day, and did it for 23 years.
Pacific Hills Drive should be it, so.
Mark Burr, I've never
went to
teacher jail. How did he not go to teacher jail? Oh, there it is. He's got his pants down around his neck.
See if we can't see the bodies coming out. Try to talk to neighbors and identify who the people are, because right now the media is not saying who, you know, who lived there, who's dead. Could be someone that I know or my family knows. But yeah, everybody's dead. Four dead. I guess there was a welfare check to check on one of the people in the house. Maybe one of the minors.
You and I are in class together. As much as I got slapped by pinched by a few nuns, that's worse, isn't it? Yeah. I mean, all of us talk about our Catholic grade school behavior and, you know, getting hit over
the head. I found the bodies.
I had a teacher that went to, I think, teacher jail for being inappropriate.
So,
and a biology teacher, Mr. Weckel.
So we're about 5 minutes away if we hit every single green light, and I don't know what to expect, how close we could get to this house with this crime scene, if they blocked the whole street off, but this should be a heart-pounding moment when we arrive on Pacific Hills Drive, see what we're going to see, or can we even get to it? I don't want cops to arrest me for... intruding and trying to get too close to the crime scene, you know, like that dude with his Rottweiler out of Hawthorne, California. You know, all he was doing was being a bystander, like hundreds of others, busting out his phone and videotaping or taking pictures. And cops wanted to pick a fight with him, and they shot and killed his dog and arrested him. Yeah, that was some BS. So, you know, I'm gonna try to get some footage of the bodies being carted out and talk to some neighbors. Turn right onto Oso, taking a second right onto Pacific Drive, and this is it right here, up here. Don't know how close we can get, but here we go. You guys probably don't have, how many people can say that they, end up on a street where there was a murder suicide and a whole family of four dead? So here we go.
John Ken Show, Shannon has the news.
A memorial service is being held at UC Santa Barbara for the six students killed near campus over the weekend. Three were shot at a deli and island. La Vista. Three others were stabbed to death in their apartment. Classes were canceled at UC Santa Barbara today. The school declared a day of mourning and reflection, and UC President Janet Napolitano ordered flags at all 10 UC campuses lowered to half staff. Traffic from your helpful SoCal Honda Traffic Center.
Oh, damn, this is right on the border of, like, Nelly, you know, where every year they have this rich mansion and the whole street putting on a crazy Christmas light show. The house is whole, the inside of the house is decked out. It's like the mayor of Laguna Hills owns this thing, and right up ahead, like straight up into those hills up there, that's like Nelly Gill. So we're on the very border of Mission Viejo.
And that's going to be very jammed coming off the 134 over to that point. You'll slow again.
We're going across the 5 freeway right now.
Downtown, the 110 flowing ride from the 101 southbound. You'll stay pretty busy off and on toward the 105. Mike Nolan, KFI traffic.
News brought to you by American Comfort Air Conditioning and Heating. Hillary Clinton says President Obama's decision to send Navy SEALs in to get Osama bin Laden was one of the toughest she took part in during her 4 years as Secretary of State.
As is usually the case with the benefit of hindsight, I wish we could go back.
I'm sure we're going to see news crews. They better make some room for a NewsBall.
From Clinton's upcoming memoir, Hard Choices, she says she wrote the book for Americans and other people trying to make sense of what she calls a rapidly changing world. One fun fact.
All right, so it's 4:38 on Tuesday, the 27th, I think, of May. 2014, and about to take you onto the street of a murder-suicide family of four, and I don't think many people ever end up on a street where there's an active crime scene involving four dead bodies, so this is an inside look, a glimpse into what that may look like. I don't know if the whole street's going to be blocked off, if we're going to see the bodies being carted out, if there's going to be news crews and vans and cameramen already there, but this was breaking news like 30 minutes ago at 4 p.m. or so, and so since I was just 5 miles away, I'm headed over to it, trying to push my way in and let them know NewsBall's here, make way. Gosh, it's rush hour since it's almost 5, so we're getting like totally backed up on these street lights. Might not even make this green light. But this will be a heart-pounding moment as we approach the street of Pacific Hills Drive. Just to see, just to know that you're in the presence of a bunch of dead bodies, a huge crime. This is in the wake of the Santa Barbara massacre, the Hunger Games killer, just a couple days ago. Seriously, how is this the worst lane possible? How are the cars going, flying by on both sides of me? God damn. It's gotta be them because of the murder up here. We're less than a mile away now. Fuck. All of you watching this in the southeast, I bet you're like laughing at the life we have to deal with out here. Yeah, we got good weather, we got the beaches. But real estate's insane. Traffic's insane. Can't even go a mile with freaking 20 red lights. Oh shit, here it is. Pacific Hills. So this rich neighborhood, it looks like. What happened? Did the dad lose his job and then he couldn't feel like a man providing for his family anymore, so he decided to kill his kids, his wife, and himself? Is that what happened? We will find out. Well, We'll see how close we get. All they said was like the 25,000 block of Pacific Hills Drive, and I'm on it. I think it's coming up. Oh, damn. Wow. Yep. That's crazy. Look at that. Locked off and everything. It's crazy. Try to get on the other side of it. Those cops were staring me down. They're probably like running my license plate right now, which says NewsBall. I'm like, what's this NewsBall? Is this a suspect? Is he someone that helped kill this family? All right, I'm gonna try to get on the other side of this. I'm gonna park. I don't know how to get on the other side, but we'll see. Trail that'll put me behind it. That's what I'll do if I have to. Should wrap around and put me down on the other side. I don't think we're gonna capture much excitement on this vlog, but I hope you enjoyed my random banter and observations. But we'll try to be a little pushy here and see how close I can get. Okay, so here's the other side of Pacific Hills Drive. That says Pacific Hills Drive. I'll park on this street and I'll park and see what's up. Cops don't think this is a gun and start shooting me. You know, crimes. They're probably on edge, like with Christopher Dorner. Christopher Dorner was shooting up all of Southern California. Those cops shot at a lady with throwing newspapers out of her van. Yeah, here we go. All right, we're in the heart. We're in the heart of this thing. NBC's already here. Damn. Everybody's already here. Bartiromo with NewsBall. We're walking down the street of a murder-suicide family of four. Apparently four dead. We got NBC right here. And we got... Damn, talk about an intrusion. Look at this. ABC's already here. More NBC. Damn, Telemundo's here. That's hilarious. Telemundo. KCAL. Man, that's crazy. So, see, like, oh man, they don't let you get anywhere near this thing. Stand by, we'll see what happens. Maybe they'll hold a press conference in a bit or cart out some bodies. So we got NBC's Vicky Vargas here. That's awesome.
I think it was four. No, I don't think so.
So we have NBC's Vicky Vargas, Fox 11 News somebody, and CBS somebody. And they're starting to report. They're still worried about the safety and well-being of some people, and they can't reveal anything yet, and that the suspect is dead. So stay tuned. So this is what it's like to have a neighborhood go through a mass murder, whole family wiped out, and this is the media circus that ensues. None of these houses can get into their driveways. Media's blocked them off. And damn, I wish I had a better camera right now. Maybe we're gonna be carting bodies out. Hey Vicky, my name's Cole. You interviewed me 10 years ago.
Recognize the face?
Before I went to jail for bank fraud. We interviewed at the lake,
yes.
The Ladera Ranch, Wells Fargo Bank,
yeah.
The whole conspiracy
yeah.
case. So, you know, I got
oh my goodness,
out.
10 years.
10 years. So I'm out, and I'm running my own website right now, newsball.com.
Oh, yeah?
And your channel, Dateline, did the murder of Skylar Neese last month. And I was in it as like the correspondent for NewsBall. I broke that case. I exposed those killers. So, and now, hey, this was down the street. My aunt said, hey, this murder-suicide just went down your city. Go check it out. So might as well do a little vlog on it.
That's a whole new career for you.
Yeah, it just fell in my lap. I wasn't even looking to do it. But you got to play the cards you're dealt, right?
Mm-hmm.
And especially when you're a felon, so.
How long ago, how much time did you end up doing?
It was a 33-month sentence. And yeah, I got out in 2006. And then there was 3 years of federal supervision, which it was suffocating.
I was going to say, I don't see any braces.
No, yeah. I broke my leg in prison.
Oh.
But that was 2009, 2010. You know, so 4 years absolutely clear, free of clear of everything. But yeah, I was like, oh yeah, Vicky
yeah.
Vargas is
We're
here. Awesome.
Here. Yeah. Thanks for saying hi.
Yeah. So that's the house up ahead. Man, you guys know me. You guys know what NewsBall's about. I'm so tempted to just go through this freaking police tape, just go up into the house and get some exclusive footage for y'all. Take some pics of the crime scene and all that, but damn, man. Trespassing would be the least of my worries, huh? If that's all it was, I would do it. But that's messing with a crime scene. Shit, what is it? That's fucking tampering with evidence, obstructing justice, all kinds of shit. So, oh, man. They got us taped off so far back, though. That's a bust. Like, look at the two different areas of tape, you know?
They don't need this area of tape. Why can't we go up to that one?
So I don't think there's going to be anything else happening here. That's funny how they work. They just say like one sentence, little tidbits, and then they'll edit it all up later, I guess. Because they're just saying like, lie from here, blah, blah, blah. And they just say like one thing. That dude just said, it's confined to one house and no one's in danger. That's it, and that's all he did, and they stopped recording. It's funny how the process works. You know, it's interesting and funny at the same time. It's like just, oh, what are they bringing in? Everyone's moving about, trying to get like angles for the big moment when they cart out the bodies and stuff. It's like just business as usual for the media world. Four dead bodies just 100 feet away, and everyone's here just trying to get what they need to earn their paycheck this week. Saying the family was active at the Mount Lutheran Church, and the neighbors just can't believe that that could be them inside dead. Police tape on the backside too. I was thinking about walking up from the back, see what I can see, look in, but nah, they got that blocked off too. Damn, look at that, neighbors everywhere. What does she know? Look at her, she knows something. She's not gonna talk though. She's not talking.
Dang, can you imagine all these people here?
Looking at that house and imagining the people they knew all dead inside. That's crazy. Mobile command center trailer right there. So yeah, I was up on that end. That cop right there in that tent staring me down when I drove up.
It's funny, you got all the reporters just camping out. That's the CBS
reporter just chilling, lounging back on her cell phone, waiting for the next report.
You got Vicky Vargas, hard to see her, but she's sitting in her van.
All the reporters just taking a break, camping out, and then they'll all line back up for their next live report as soon as the cops give them a little more information. So, it's so funny how this process works. Boom, NewsBall. That's right, NewsBall on the scene. As we grow, all right, we'll take a little break. Since all the other reporters are chilling out, camping out in their cars now, I'll do the same thing. Damn, everyone's starting to get home. Look at that. That's awesome. But yeah, I blend right in. I'm gonna ask her. Everyone's starting to get home, and I don't think they even know what happened. So, let's see. Hey, do you know those neighbors?
No, I lived off the whole house.
Yeah.
It's so sad. It feels like a jungle. I mean.
Yeah, it's so creepy, huh? That house is empty now.
But they were a type of family. From what I saw, the decorations, but every holiday they decorate. Yeah. They have those houses that, no matter if it's whatever, if it's Easter or Halloween or Valentine's, they always decorated the front yard.
I've been hearing little tidbits that the reporters keep saying, like one sentence, and then they record for a second, and they keep, you know. And they said the family went to St. Lutheran Church or Mount Lutheran Church, so they, you know, they're church going family. And that it's just all contained to that one house, so everyone else is safe, and that the suspect is dead.
I'm assuming it was a family.
Yeah.
Thing.
And I thought I heard him say that there were no children there. So I don't know, four adults?
Yeah.
Were there kids at that house?
I don't know. I do know that house in particular always stood out.
Yeah.
Wow. Any little holiday, they decorated the front lawn. Anything, whether it was just. You know, I don't decorate for every holiday. I don't decorate Valentine's or Easter. But they definitely did. They were known for that. So it might have been a mom doing all the decorating.
Yeah. Some people are getting home not knowing what's going on.
I know.
I'm surprised there's not more media, because I've seen media circus scenes. And so that one house there, they can't even get in their driveway with all these cars in their way.
So I'm wondering how the police came. There must have been some kind of sound or something.
I heard that the bodies might be like in there for a day, so it may have happened yesterday. I'm not sure on it, because they speak real low, because they got their microphones, so I was trying to listen to these reporters. They keep filming, but I'm pretty sure that they said that the bodies have been there maybe for a day. I'm just waiting it out, seeing if they're gonna do get a statement or a press conference. Or all the reporters did their report, and now they're sitting in their vans, and then I think they're gonna go back down there at 6 to do another live report. I live 5 miles away, and my aunt who lives in Corona said, oh my god, Cole, like, there was a murder in your city.
Yeah.
Whole family, go check it out. So I'm over here, and I told my mom, and my mom said, oh, Caitlin,
has a friend that lives right here, and that's my sister, Caitlin. Uh-huh. So I'm just here because, you know, I live in the area. Yeah. I don't live on the street, though.
Yeah, I have about four houses up here.
So I just texted my sister, who's at school in Seattle, and I said, oh my God, you know, the Pacific Hills, uh-huh. is your friend on this street? So I haven't heard back yet.
Our community is called Pacific Hills, and also the street is Pacific Hills.
Yeah.
So it's kind of, I thought when somebody told me, oh, it's in Pacific Hills, I said, oh, it must be in my community. It's like, no, it's on your street.
Yeah, first I was on the other side of Pacific Hills.
Right, there's a couple entrances.
Yeah, so I was trying to get in from the other side, and the cops have that side way blocked off, far away.
Oh.
And there's a cop car right by the tape on way over there. And they were staring at me, so I had to like do a U-turn and go into a driveway to do a U-turn. But
this lady's got to show identification.
Oh, whoa.
See her?
Yes. Yeah,
she showed her wallet.
Oh, maybe she's a closer neighbor.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was like an hour or two ago on the news, so. Let's see, I don't know if they've carted the bodies out yet. They said the suspect is dead and it's confined to that one house, and that the bodies may have been there for a day now. So it wasn't an active crime scene, or it's a crime scene. Yeah, no one's on the loose, and they're just trying to get all the DNA probably and see what happened.
That's something you hear about News Media all the time.
Yeah, my aunt in Corona said, oh my God, Cole, there was a murder suicide in your city, a whole family, go check it out, see, you know, because my sister has a friend that lives on this street or right in this neighborhood. So I texted her to see if it's this girl's that she knows.
Yeah, it's kind of a long street, but most of it, not homes on most of it. Starts up there, but down towards the bottom. I figured it was down this edge.
Yeah, I tried to get in from the other side first, and they have it blocked off a good six houses that way too.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you can not letting anyone get anywhere near it.
I was just gonna drive through to get my daughter, but I should have figured the street would block it off.
Oh. Hard trying to film people and talk to them. I need a cameraman. So, oh damn, they opened up the garage the whole way. Damn, we should interview her. So I wonder what would happen if I had this device that this there was this aerial cam, kind of what Amazon's going to start doing, like flying in your mail to you, right? Anything you order, they're going to fly it to you on like a freaking spaceship. What if I had this like aerial device with a camera and I just flew it on in and landed it in their backyard and, you know, started taking pictures and video of, you know, of what's inside. I mean, what would the cops do about that? I mean, that's not me trespassing. Fuck, I'm so tempted. This is bullshit. Look at this. That's mass media for you right there. Just lining up cameras. I gotta get an exclusive here. So I either need to run on through this tape and go inside and get my footage of the crime scene, or I need to go strap a camera onto some sort of flying device with a remote control and fly it on in there and get my visuals that way. This is BS, man. It sucks. I kind of want to ask this cop what would happen if I had a device that could do that. Wow, talk about overkill. Look at this. Another ABC Eyewitness News is pulling up. It's like you already got one there and another there. Like, why do they send out three trucks? Yeah, tried to sit on that rock, but that cop told me no. They say, here they come. Damn, intense.
That was number one.
One body out.
This is the scene of a murder-suicide. However, what we don't know yet is the identities of the dead and whether it may be the family who lived here.
Now neighbors and bystanders are starting to crowd the areas. People are getting off work and coming on down. Rotundo, or you know that name, Mary Ann Rotundo. She's out of New York. I guess she's one of the producers of Dateline. So I was doing a lot of back and forth with her.
Officials are not saying what the motive here was or the manner of death. Live in Mission Viejo, I'm Michelle Gielo. Officials won't say how the victims died or what the motive may have been, but the neighbors and the authorities confirm that there never were any signs of trouble here. In Mission Viejo, Michelle Gielo, KPIX 5.
What do you think the cops would do if you had like an aerial device with a video camera on it and you just like flew it on into the backyard? I mean, is that a charge? Because we didn't trespass. We're here. So want to do that. For them? I might just ask the cop, huh? Put that in my vlog. I wonder if they ever thought about doing that. I'm going to ask them. Hey, have you guys ever thought about aerial devices and you fly it on in there with video camera on it? Or what would the cops say to that?
Here?
Well, on scenes, yeah, where they try to stop you from getting footage. I mean, what kind of charge would that be?
Well, it'd be very disrespectful. I love them.
Well, any sort of scene where they're blocking you off and can't get close.
That's why we have those things in the sky.
Yeah.
That's why we use our helicopter.
I know what you mean, like the GoPro helicopter.
Yeah, well, I mean, Amazon's going to start doing that, delivering your orders with an aerial device.
I think they're working on red light rules to regulate that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
They haven't yet, so I imagine...
I mean, I just tried to sit by that rock right there, and the cop was telling me to get back. It's like, come on. No need to be that strict.
Yeah.
Just trying to get an angle, and so I was just like, yeah, what if you have an aerial device that you tape a video camera onto it?
I think it depends on most circumstances. And crime scene, maybe. Limited obstruction of justice, some sort of tampering.
I'm gonna ask them. I'm gonna go ask this cop. I'm trying to get into the news business. I have a little blog.
That's what
I did. So if I had a device, like an aerial little device with a camera strapped onto it, and I flew it on into there, what would you guys do? Is that a crime?
Yeah, you can't have it under certain investigations. It's a reasonable.
Yeah, so I would be in trouble if I had a film, and I had like, you know, Amazon's going to start doing that with orders. Mail you your orders by air.
Investigation.
Yeah.
scary, totally curious, random question.
You know, you can't do that with an investigation. You'll be in trouble. I was like, well, I mean, what kind of charge is it? Da, da, da. You know, I was looking for specifics, but he was just kind of giving me real short answers. It just kind of like not saying it, but get out of my face.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't think they're, they don't, because I know there are lots of places that are looking into it because it's become a problem in certain circumstances.
Privacy laws.
Yeah, yeah.
There was a flash up in that
room. I think they're writing up something as we speak.
Yeah.
I know there's a guy up at Dana Point that takes, you know, he takes people out whale watching.
Yeah.
And then he flies his GoPro over and shoots, you know, aerial footage on his helicopter.
Uh-huh.
But that's cool. It won't be long and they'll say, you know, I can't do that because it's harassing the whale. You know, they'll shut it down eventually. You know.
PETA's going to step in.
You never know. You can only take your boat so close to a whale, so they'll probably make some kind of air clearance too.
Okay.
But so far, as far as I know, there aren't any rules. I know that lots of people are upset about it. They're going to eventually be limited.
It's hard to keep track of, you know, the most recent changes in laws. Everything changes like a chameleon with the society we have, technology.
As far as I know, they're not regulated.
Yeah. You know, you can't do that with an investigation. You'll be in trouble. I was like, well, I mean, what kind of charge is it? Da, da, da. You know, I was looking for specifics, but he was just kind of giving me real short answers. It just kind of like not saying it, but get out of my face.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't think they're, they don't, because I know there are lots of places that are looking into it because it's become a problem in certain circumstances.
Privacy laws.
Yeah, yeah.
There was a flash up in that room.
I think they're writing up something as we speak.
Yeah.
I know there's a guy up at Dana Point that takes, you know, he takes people out whale watching.
Yeah.
And then he flies his GoPro over and shoots, you know, aerial footage on his helicopter.
Uh-huh.
But
that's cool.
It won't be long and they'll say, you know, I can't do that because it's harassing the whale.
They'll
shut it down eventually. You know.
PETA's going to step in.
You never know. You can only take your boat so close to a whale, so they'll probably make some kind of air clearance too.
Okay.
But so far, as far as I know, there aren't any rules. I know that lots of people are upset about it. They're going to eventually be limited.
It's hard to keep track of, you know, the most recent changes in laws. Everything changes like a chameleon with the society we have, technology.
As far as I know, they're not regulated. So.
I'm assuming. Here they come.
It's four adults or four grown people.
I think one's a girl, I think.
Like a teen?
High school.
Well, I think what happened is that mom and dad thought it seemed like it. They got a hold of their son and daughter. They've probably been a bigger day.
All right, thank you.
Now I gotta find another partner.
Yeah, and I would go like
I think that's a big deal.
That's tragic. The daughter's friend came and said, now I gotta find another partner.
Well, I was kidding. But she did, but they did say she was supposed to be doing a big school project with her. And that's what made her concerned because it's a big project.
And it's graduation time, so it's like their final project.
It's probably
how do you know that the dad is giving the house?
Because when I was
in the house, the dad is giving the house. And then the parents move back in. No, that's a key. Oh, sure.
That's the kind of sense of humor we have.
No, but yeah, if that really, that stuff piques my interest, because if someone like that needs to be exposed on my website, I have newsball.com, and we expose, we try to get a different angle on stories. So if the neighbor's saying something like that.
No, I mean, the mom came and she said, yeah, we've been trying to call her all morning. So that's why I came down. I was going to see why I can't get her on the phone.
Yeah.
My daughter's her best friend, and they have a big school project to finish.
At Saddleback? Is that the
one? No, the girl's only like 15. So she's like a freshman.
Mission High, maybe, or?
No, she goes to Lutheran, what is it? A Lutheran Christian school around here. Okay.
Damn, a whole slew showed up. 1, 2, 3. So this is what the media scene looks like when there's a family murdered. This is the media circus that shows up. With helicopters too. All right, so I hope NewsBall brought something interesting to you there. For those of you who want to see what it's looked like to be on the street of a murdered family, there you go. That's the media circus for you. So it's so macabre and like morbid and. As you know, just all these onlookers and all these cameras there to get pictures of the bodies coming out, you know, on the gurneys. And everyone does the count, like, there's one, here's the first, they're making way, here's the first. And then, you know, they're counting, there's two, that's an adult. And then three, that's another adult, so no children yet. And, you know, so there's four bodies, they were all adult size, and it turns out, you know, one's a 15-year-old female and one's a 20-something-year-old, you know, son, and then the mom and dad. But yeah, they were all like, you know, everyone's looking to see if they're like big bodies or small bodies to see if, you know, how many adults, how many children were killed in this thing. So it's just like such a weird thing to witness, to see like it. That whole scene, that whole media circus, that's all about business, you know? It's all about them making money, all about them doing a story, reporting the story, and it's just surreal, man, to think, like, that whole family, that whole house just got wiped out, and they're all there, you know, like, doing a count on how many bodies have come out, and it's just really weird. So, definitely something to witness, you know, at least once, just to see, man, that's how the media industry works. That's the process, how they all line up and go a lot, you know, they record one sentence, go off, and it's just, everything's so rehearsed. Nothing is spontaneous. Nothing is just from their heart. Nothing is raw and uncensored. It's all scripted. They're all just talking heads.
that have been in the biz for years, so they get those gigs as reporters. It's like I said, I knew Vicky Vargas from NBC 10 years ago when she interviewed me when I was in high school. So, man, it's just, anyways, hope you guys found that vlog interesting. I'm sorry I couldn't break through the police tape and get you some footage inside the house, but I wasn't willing to go to jail tonight. Maybe there will be times in the future while I'm willing to break a law or two in order to get you an exclusive, create some extra controversy. But you know, if I did that right now, they were just going to confiscate my phone and throw me in the back of a cop car, so there's no point in doing that. I really need to come up with an aerial device. I could strap a little camera to it and then, you know, land it right on into the backyard and get some footage through the window. That's what I need to do. But, yeah, there's just nothing to be done there. Nothing exciting to see. Hopefully it was educational, though, and you got something out of it. Hopefully it's interesting.